Hi everyone, Holly here with Texas Parks and Wildlife Department's Coastal Fisheries Division. Our coastal fisheries biologists frequently have to identify many different types of fish as a part of their jobs. For example, after using this type of net called a seine, our biologists will identify, count, and measure everything that they catch in that net. We use this information to make predictions about what the fish populations look like along the Texas coast and to propose changes to the fishing regulations if needed. However, we may run into something that we don't see very often, or there may be two or three fish species that look really similar. So to make sure that we're collecting accurate data, we want to make sure that we're identifying these animals correctly. To help us do that, we'll use things like field guides or even dichotomous keys. A dichotomous key is almost like a choose-your-own-adventure book. The key will give you two choices, and you have to pick the one that best fits with the item you're trying to identify. So when we're trying to identify things like fish, we'll be asked about their coloration, body shape, patterns, and even the number of rays that they have on their fins. So after making your decision, the key will give you more directions, usually instructing you to make a choice between two more statements. And you'll continue to do this until you get to your answer. You'll always want to start at step one and work your way through the key. If you start halfway through the key, you may misidentify your item. So now let's practice using a dichotomous key with this monster here using this key over here. Remember, we always want to start with step one. Step one for this key is asking us to identify whether or not this monster has legs. I don't see any legs, so let's look on the right side of our key, and that'll be where the key is going to give us more directions. So it looks like the key is asking us to move on to step number two. So if we look at step two, our key is going to be now asking us to identify whether or not our monster is furry. I don't see any fur on this little guy, so it looks like we are now going to skip step three and move on to step four. Step four is asking us about the color of our monster. Is it black and white or is it colorful? He's a really pretty purple and yellow, right? So he's pretty colorful. From here, the key is telling us to move on now to step five. And step five is asking us to look at the pattern. What kind of pattern do you guys see on our monster? He's got a lot of spots, right? So it looks like we finally found our answer. This little monster is a spotted serpent. Congratulations, guys. We just identified a monster using a dichotomous key. So now let's use a different key to identify a fish species. So we're going to use a new key for this process. The key is now up on the side of the screen, and the fish we're going to identify is right back here behind me. We're going to try to identify this fish here. So step one, remember, we always want to start with step one, and step one is asking us whether or not our fish has a compressed body shape. So when we say compressed body shape here, we're pretty much talking about a flatfish, so things like flounder. Flounder have both eyes on one side of their head and spend most of their time laying on the bottom of the ocean. So what do you guys think? Does this fish have a compressed body shape? To me, this looks like just a regular fish, right? So this fish does not have a compressed body shape, and according to our key, we are now going to move on to step number three. Step three is asking us whether or not this fish has a single eye spot near its tail. So while this fish does have a lot of spots, it does not have one single eye spot near its tail. So now according to the key, we're going to move on to step number four. Now we need to determine whether or not our fish has any stripes. So again, we're going to get close up to the camera here. While I see some patterning with some spots, I don't see any stripes on this guy. So it looks like we're going to move on to step six. Is our fish a greenish color with spots? We talked about those spots earlier, and it sure does look like it has a greenish color to it, right? So that means this fish is a spotted sea trout. Congratulations, guys! We used a dichotomous key to identify a fish species. If you want extra practice using a dichotomous key to identify fish species, use this key that's on the screen here to identify this fish species. If you haven't had time to figure it out yet and you still want to, go ahead and pause the video now because I'm about to reveal the answer. So this fish here and this one here, they're both red drum. Is that the answer you got? I hope it was. If you want even more practice with dichotomous keys, try creating your own. Use these fish that are on the screen now to create your own key and then have your friends, family, or classmates try to identify a fish based on your key. The keys I used today were made specifically for this video, so you won't be able to use them to identify just any fish you go out and catch in the Gulf. However, you can find a lot of really great resources online to do that. Check out the wildlife fact sheets that we have on the Texas Parks and Wildlife Department webpage. You might find those really helpful in trying to identify some of the more common species that we have here in Texas. To keep up with the Coastal Fisheries Division, be sure to check us out on Facebook at TPWD Coastal.